in this video, we'll be looking at how to paint some quick Viperous snake skin. These hypnotic patterns are a stark warning to anything that comes too close. Sekar's tamed pet and former death god Ouboroth will be the model that we're painting in our guide, but you can use this on any snakes or scaly creatures in your collection. The paints we'll be using are on the screen right now. The great thing about this guide is you can change the colours depending on your models, using the same techniques in mind. We've also got a list of the additional equipment we've used, but you can use whatever brushes you feel most comfortable with. If you're new to painting or want to brush up on your skills, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn all about paints and techniques. For our cold-blooded friend here, we've popped him on a sub-assembly peg and undercoated him in grey sear, as this will give us a cold tone for all our colours. So let's get painting. To lay out the dark patterning along our snake, we'll apply Corvus Black over the head to start with, finishing at the top of the back with a point that points down the body. This is a great way to start off the rest of the chevron markings we'll replicate, all the way down to the end of the tail. As the body of the snake is organic and flexible, we want to make sure that the stretched sides of the lines are thinner and slightly curved, as the skin is stretching. And the opposite side is a thicker line and less curved. This will give us a more natural patterning to the skin. Our medium layer brush here makes this easier, as we can control how wide our first coat all the way down is. We can always add another coat to make the colour even more solid all the way down. Once we have our dark pattern laid out and dry, we can focus on the lighter pattern between with Rakar flesh. This acts also for our tidy up for the Corvus Black, so take your time and keep your pattern as equal in size and shape as you can on those much bigger areas. Over the grey sear undercoat, we shouldn't need more than a few thinned layers, but you may find you need one more over any stray Corvus Black. But don't worry if you make any of the dark patterns too thin again, we can always tidy back over with Corvus Black after. Some areas will be easier to paint than others, so take your time and work slowly over the scales. All over Ouboroth are these tiny but sharp looking diamond shaped scales, almost like horns. For these, we'll be using Dawnstone and just picking out the ones along the top of his back, as this will make the snake look cool but won't take as long if we did it all over. We'll also use this to base coat Ouboroth's face, belly and jaw. If you really wanted to and had lots of time, you could pick out all the Rakarth flesh scales up to this colour too, but this will take lots of time and you may find that you need to do some tidying up. On the other hand, you could skip this step completely on your scaly friend if they don't have any type of this detail. Next, we'll apply Nuln Oil lightly over all our scales and skin. We don't want to apply this too heavily, as it can make some areas look too hard or patchy. So apply it in sections all along the snake, and it will settle naturally between all those scales. If it does pool in places, we can take a dry brush and soak it away. We can always add more once it's dried and looking great. Now let's look at those lighter scales again. Now we have the pattern on the skin and the scales shaded, we'll layer on the belly and face, jaw and the top of the scales with a few coats of Administratum Grey, getting some great definition to those grey details. We just want to make sure the muzzle of the snake is painted, but it finishes off with little spikes, so they blend into the black skin with ease. With these spiky scales on his back, you can use the side of your brush and gently run it along the top of those scales. Just be light and use slow, multiple strokes. Now that our snake here has a hypnotic pattern and its belly is nice and clean, we can add some dry brushing for some definition to the body. And to finish off our scales, we'll be using a light dry brush of pallid witch flesh over the scales. We'll be using directional dry brushing, so we pick out the scale's highest points, rather than covering all of it. This will pick out the black scales as well as the lighter ones at the same time, even all those grey ones along its back too. Just remember to be light in application, as we don't want to overwhelm the scales and leave a dusty finish on the model too. With that dry brush, our simplified scaly slithering snake is now complete. All you need to do now is pick out the rest of your colours for any of the details on your creature. Here I've popped some Galvor Back Red in the mouth, Wraithbone on the fangs, and Temple Guard Blue for the eyes. Look how happy he is on his base, consuming the souls of the damned. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, check out our videos on the Warhammer YouTube channel, or head to your local Warhammer store, where our amazing staff would be happy to help you. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!